all the praise and all the glory. Amen. Because it's because of him and the journey that I have been through for the last 30 years since I was baptized. Amen. That I have the courage and the faith in him to know that I can stand before you here today to deliver what God has placed on my heart for all of us. Before I go into that, I have to give props to my family who have come out to support and encourage me. My beloved mother is here. Amen. A woman who's so dear and precious to me. Mom, stand up. Please, I want the church to see who brought this individual here and who has guided and directed me through my life. Thank you. An incredible woman. An incredible woman. And my sister Maureen has also turned up. Stand up, sis. This young lady here has been another individual in my life who has guided me and directed me and been such an incredible source of encouragement. And there's another individual who's here I'm so proud of. It really touched my heart that she came here, and that's Jade. Jade, please stand up. This is my wife's daughter, Jade. She's coming with her two children today. And I'm just so grateful that you made the effort to do that. It means a lot to me.
And your wife.
Really does. Now, brethren, family, I want to talk to you today because when I had the opportunity to prepare this, I prayed about it long. A lot of different things came into my mind as to what to speak about today. And then yesterday, I sat down and everything just started to come together, right? It flowed. I sat there and everything just came into place. So I know this is not of me, okay? Please don't think this is of me. This is what God is saying to each and every one of us here today, all right?
Amen.
And what I want you to know, brethren, is this. It is not by chance that we are here today.
Amen.
You may have thought you were just coming for a christening or just to, you know, pass the time or warm the seats or whatever. But I'm telling you this right now. God has a place in his family for each and every one of you.
Amen.
Right? Listen to me good. Listen to me good. Right? From before time existed, God knew who he wanted in his family. He knew that he wanted you because you are unique. There is something that is intrinsically special about you that makes God say, yes,
amen.
I want to have a relationship with this individual.
Amen.
And brethren, it's time we start to pay attention to what the Lord is saying to us.
Amen.
He made the biggest step, the first step, by sending his son to die for us. In John 3:16, he said, God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son so that who believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. And something else that struck me is that while we were at enemies, it says in the Bible, because our ways were contrary to his ways, we didn't care about him. We didn't want to know about him or his way of life. He still was prepared to die for us. Now, you know, you see movies where an individual is attempting to wrestle a knife from somebody and they may dive in the way of a friend and they may be stabbed or they may be shot. Christ's death was not like that. It was an instant. It was protracted. It was drawn out. It was agonizing. It was humiliating.
You're preaching gospel.
But yet still,
amen,
he was prepared to do that for us.
Yes.
While we were enemies.
Yes.
Right? While we were enemies. Think about that for a moment. Because I know this much. I would not lay down my life for an enemy. Would you? Would you? No. But Christ was prepared to do that. So that was the first step in doing that. Now, I've got notes here, but you know something? I don't think I'm going to use it tough today, right? I really don't, because I don't want to detract from what I think God is trying to say to us. And I've got four principles that came to me regarding how we should develop spiritually or to aid us in developing spiritually. Because none of us are here just to sit down and warm the seats. Right? If we're not moving forward, family, we are stagnated, right? You look at everything in life and it is moving forward, right? Everything is moving forward. So if we aren't moving forward in our spiritual development and our growth, we are dying. Mm-hmm. We are dying, literally, right? God does not call us to just sit down on our dead words. There's a parable about the rich man who went and left his servants with talents and abilities and gifts. And he said to them, when I'm away, add to these gifts. Don't just sit down on them or bury them, right? And the Bible says he was an austere man, which means a serious man, a person you can ramp with. Yeah? All right. So now, there were some of the servants, they decided to hide and bury their gifts and their talents. Another servant, he decided to add one more to his talent. And another one added five. So when this austere man returned and said, well, what have you done with these talents and these gifts that I have given you? The first one said, well, you're an austere man, and I fear you, and I didn't want to upset you, so I buried mine. Because, you know, at least you still got it. You still got it, haven't you? Now, God wasn't pleased with that. The man wasn't pleased with that because he said to add to his talent. The one who added one talent to his talent, the austere man said, well done, you did well. Here's another one for you again on top of that. The one that added the five talents to his talent, the God said, well done. The man said, well done, sorry. Add five more to what you have done. So the message is we have to add to what we have and what God has done for us. So if you want a title for this sermon today, it is spiritual growth. Spiritual growth. And as I've mentioned, there's four things that God spoke to me and said, you know, talk to us. Let's discuss this and let's try and move forward as a family, because that is what we are. I don't care whether we're believers, if we're just here today, whatever. God sees us all as his family.
Amen.
So we have to grow together because of the love that he has showed for us.
Amen.
So the first point, brethren, now I know some of you already know these, it doesn't matter. Sometimes repetition is good, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the first point is to pray.
Yes.
Right? Personal prayer is something that a lot of us, myself included, don't always do as we should. If we're honest, do you understand me? If we're honest. But the thing is, prayer is such a powerful thing. It can change the atmosphere. It can change lives. It can produce gifts and talents and ability, and also bring us out of situations that are crushing, that are debilitating. The power of prayer, brethren, family, is untold. There's just so much that can be said about it. But there are different forms of prayer. There's formal prayer, where we kneel down. Say, for example, at the end of the day, we kneel down at our bedside and, you know, we pray to God, and we say what we've, you know, how our lives have been throughout the day, and we ask and beseech him to help us in certain ways. And there's a template in the Bible for those of us who don't necessarily know how to pray, which is already in Matthew, which is the Lord's Prayer. And that basically outlines the structure of a prayer, a formal prayer, whereby at the beginning of our prayer, we always glorify God.
Amen.
And give him the praise, because
Amen.
Without him, life would not exist.
Amen.
He's the essence of all things.
Yes.
And outside of him, brethren, there is no life.
Amen.
Despite what we see and we hear out there, right? I've been baptized for 30 years, and in my journey, I have seen a lot of things. And I know, beyond a shadow of a doubt, brethren, that outside of God, there is nothing. The temporary joy that you may have out there, where you're going from one high to the next, is only good for that moment.
Mm.
But when? Oh, Jesus. Praise your
name. Hallelujah.
Mighty God, wonderful Jesus. When the hand of God touches you in your life,
hallelujah,
and you feel him because he's real,
hallelujah,
you know what the real truth and the goodness is.
Yes.
You know what life really is.
Come on, brother.
It's not just the physical things, brethren.
Hallelujah.
It's just that comfort, that knowing that regardless of what we go through in life, that he's there.
Yes. present help.
His word, I will never leave you.
Preaching gospel. Right? Hallelujah.
God cannot lie.
Hallelujah.
And it says in his word, what I say, it will be accomplished. My word does not return to me void.
Hallelujah.
Praise his name.
Hallelujah.
When God makes a promise to us,
yes,
about what he's going to do for us, brethren, he means it, and he will make it happen.
Yes, he will.
He will make it happen.
Yes, he will.
Right? I'm going to be jumping all over the place, and forgive me, because this is just the way this is going to go today. Right? Think about it. There's over 6 billion people on the face of the earth.
Yes.
Over 6 billion
people
on the face of the earth. Yet still, look where you are today.
Yes.
You are in the house of the Lord.
Yes.
You think it's a coincidence? You think it's an accident?
Amen.
God wants you. As I said earlier, there is something special about you.
Amen.
That God wants to utilize, to make it grow, to water, and make it develop into that beautiful thing that he can use to bring a solution to this dying world that we're living in.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Praise his name.
Praise his name.
Moving on to the next point now.
Amen.
Let's go with prayer. The next point is Bible study. Personal Bible study.
The word.
Right? This is the bedrock, the foundation. Because without it, we don't know who God is. We can't know him unless we him revealing his identity to us.
Yes, yes.
The point that came to me was this. When we read in God's word, it is so important. Listen to me. So he did that. And they came to him and he said, no, we are not going to serve you. We trust and we serve our God.
Yes.
Right? So King Nebuchadnezzar is even more incensed. And he says to his men, heat the fire up even more on the furnace so they will burn. So now, as they're about to throw the men in there, the men who were heating up the furnace, they burnt. Right? It was them that burnt. In the fire. And it's like he said, well, weird. Wasn't it 3 men I threw into this fire?
You're preaching.
Huh? How come there's now 4 men walking around? That is not your end.
Come on.
I will deliver you.
Preach, young man.
I did deliver them, brethren.
Preach, young man.
Because this is the God we serve.
Hallelujah.
A powerful God. A mighty God. The God of praise and of peace and of love.
Hallelujah.
I call him Ed Shaddai.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Right? He is the most high God.
Hallelujah.
And there is none like him.
Hallelujah.
And brethren, everyone, I implore you, get to know God, especially now in the season that we are living in. These are serious times. There are people who have so many worries and concerns. But you know something? I am not worried. I am not worried. And I'll tell you why. Because God has given me a hope, which I have come to understand from reading his word.
Amen.
Bible study.
Amen.
Brethren, let's get with it now. Let's get with it and really push ourselves to get into God's word and find those scriptures that we can bring to mind that will remind us of God's awesome power and his deliverance.
Yes.
And also what he has in store for us. Moving on to my third point. This point is meditation. Meditation. Now you've found your scriptures. The scriptures that bolster you, that encourage you. You meditate on those scriptures. You bring them to mind. You think about them. The meaning of it and how it associates with your life. Because the thing is, I think it's Ephesians 2 verse 2. If I'm wrong, forgive me. I've got the notes. See me later. It mentions that the devil is the prince of the power of the air.
Uh-huh.
Right? Let me just explain this to you now. The devil is the prince of the power of the air. This means that he broadcasts his negativity. Yeah? His hatred, his bile. Yeah? His insidiousness. He broadcasts it into the atmosphere. Right?
Yes.
But see, here you know, if we are meditating on God's word, our minds will not have that space to catch onto that. An analogy that was used that I want to bring to you is that of a transistor radio. Now, if you're born in the 90s, you're probably going to know what a transistor radio is. It's analog, right? And this is the digital age now. But back in the day, if you wanted to tune into pirate radio, right? Pirate radio, the big radio, you had a dial on it that you had to twist to yeah. catch the frequency.
Yeah.
Yeah? And along the way, you'd get a lot of interference.
And you'll put up aerial.
You can hear what you want to tune into.
Yeah.
Right? So what would you do? You turn the knob a little bit more. Just a little bit more. And then you catch a piece of it now. So you know you're on the right track. Yeah? So then you turn back the dial and you fine tune it until you lock onto the song that you wanted to hear. Yeah?
Yeah, man.
And the analogy that I'm trying to bring to you is that our mind is like that transistor radio.
Yes.
Right? We have to make sure that when we are turning that dial to tune in, it's God's frequency that we're trying to tune into.
Yes.
Yeah? It's God's frequency that we are trying to tune into. Not getting caught up on the interference, but receiving His clear message through to us.
Yes.
So that is the importance of meditation, because when we meditate on God's word,
yes,
it's more difficult for the enemy to get a foothold on our yes. minds. Meditation, brethren. That's what we have to work towards on those scriptures.
Amen.
My final point is, that of stepping out in faith. And brethren, if you really want to see God move, for me personally, this is the one. Stepping out in faith.
Yes.
Because you see, when you pray, when you Bible study, when you meditate on His word, you have that connection with Him. You're in tune with Him. Yeah? And when He places something on your heart to do, even though it may seem impossible,
yes,
it is possible.
Yes.
But the only way we're going to know that is if we step out in faith. Sometimes, I'm going to give you a quick illustration. I'm in a job right now that apparently I was not supposed to be in. 14 years later, I'm still in that job. And by the grace of God, I am still excelling, right?
Amen.
And opportunities have come my way. When I was not in tune with God and I would back away from it, thinking, I can't do this. I am fearful of this opportunity. Because look at me, who am I? Who am I? But God has been on my journey, speaking into my life and showing me that in order for me to trust Him, I've got to step out, man. So no,
amen.
When opportunities came for me to get on certain courses, to do, I'm a graphic designer, to do software that I know nothing about, I said, yeah, okay, yeah, I'll do it. Because God has given me this opportunity, He's opened this door.
Yes.
So why shouldn't I?
Yes.
Yeah? So I stepped into that opportunity, and you know something? Just a testimony to how powerful our God is. This piece of software that I learned in my job has brought me so much accolade where I am. And it's because of Him. Not me, but Him. And I decided to step out in faith, which is what He's been telling me to do. So brethren, what I'm trying to implore you to do is don't sit down and think to yourself, I can't do that. I can't do this. But to utilize your faith. You know, this is a wonderful church. And what pleases my heart is I have seen individuals when I first came here who were in the background, and I've seen them starting to move forward and step out. Because you see, this is what we are called to do.
Yes.
God is refining us.
Yes.
And making us into something that is untouchable.
Yes.
See my brother grinning here, man. He knows what we are talking about. Untouchable.
Amen.
Yeah? Not for us, you know. Not for us, but for those around us.
Yes.
Because the blessings
yes.
that we receive.
Yes.
The knowledge and the wisdom that the Holy Spirit imparts to us.
Yes.
It's not for us alone.
Uh-huh.
We have family members. We have friends.
Yes.
We have other people that we get in contact with. They need to know that there is a solution to the crisis that they are facing.
Yes.
Right?
You're preaching.
And only God has that solution.
Yes.
Only God. So that was my fourth and final point. step out in faith. This is me stepping out in faith. Because I don't like standing up here. Honestly, I really don't. But I said to myself, you know, when God started to reveal himself to me, I can't deny you. No matter how much I was there in my chair, sweating, shaking like a leaf I'm blowing out the wind. You know, I thought, no. Because I serve a real God.
Yes.
A living God. The one true God. Jehovah Jireh, my sustainer, my provider, my ruler, my king.